Do you want a classic example of drastic change? Mathew Stafford needed just one game to equal or even outclass a couple of the Rams' deep passing benchmarks for the whole of last season. After a record 5 of 7, 197 yards plus 2 touchdowns in his second match, his last game against Chicago was 2 higher levels. He ended the game with 321 yards, 20 of 26, 3 touchdowns, and a 156.1 passer rating. Now, if that isn't one way to define incredible, I don't know what is. Just beginning the first chapter of this new story in the NFL, this superstar QB is once again the strongest prospect among quarterbacks in the game. Yes, I said again because he was once regarded as the best player from high school, so it's not new to him. The victory on Sunday was a testament to his growth as a player, as it resulted in career highs for several factors, including his passer rating and a positive mention from Al Michaels, leading the Rams to a 3-0 perfect season start. His debut is just as excellent, with many regarding it as the greatest debut by a quarterback in modern times. But how exactly did this star change the Los Angeles Rams and the NFL? This valid question is what we'll attempt to answer in this video. However, before we go deep into it, ensure you leave a like on this video if you happen to care about Mathew Stafford. Also, if you would like to join this month's giveaway of a brand new iPhone 13, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video until the end to find and comment on the hidden message. Good luck! Now, one of Mathew Stafford's incredible years was 2011 and 2012. In each of those years, the superstar quarterback threw for 4,900 yards, and with Drew Brees, they remain the only QBs in history to have done that. While with the Detroit outfit, he and Reggie Bush, the running back, were the only ones to rush for 1,000 yards. Also, Stafford recorded 11 100-yard rushers in his time with the franchise, but with time came the need for change. And as it happened, the Los Angeles team had to trade off Jared Goff to acquire Stafford in a January agreement. Immediately this happened, all hell sort of broke loose as many people started wondering about the wisdom of the trade. Like, why would you trade, arguably, your best player for a player who is a 33-year-old man? It just didn't seem smart. Well, to get a better understanding, let's dive into history a bit. The Rams drafted Goff in the 2016 NFL draft picks, but the quarterback was off to a pretty disappointing start, as he started 0-7, throwing just 5 touchdowns and 7 interceptions. Simply put, at first, his future seemed bleak. Then, like a sudden alignment in the stars, Sean McVay came in, and Jared Goff transformed to a competent starting QB. In 2017, the team went 11-5, as well as managing a Super Bowl challenge in 2018 with a 13-3 run. In Goff's defense, one terrific play was the pass he threw before halftime to Brandon Cooks, and another to Tyler Higbee in overtime. These two were significant factors that helped the Rams get to the Super Bowl. However, as it happened, the Rams got 3 points in the Super Bowl, and the disappointment resulted majorly from a missed Goff throw. And ever since, the 2019 and 2020 seasons were very unmemorable for the quarterback. Jared Goff in 2020 had a run of poor performances against teams like the Jets, Dolphins, and the 49ers, which could cost the Rams the number one seed. Then, things continued downhill for Goff after a thumb injury gave John Wolford a starting chance. And in time, it became clear that Jared's place in the team wasn't sure. Basically, it became plain that Goff's days in Los Angeles were numbered. LA's front office had such thoughts, and you can tell based on the fee they paid in picks. Now, you might wonder what things placed Mathew Stafford over Jared so high that they went through the trouble. Well, for starters, Stafford held the passer rating advantage over Goff with a 96.3 to 90.0 rating. Then there were ESPN's total quarterback ratings, where Stafford had 68.4 to Goff's 58.5. Also, there's the PFF grades, with Stafford's 82.0 to Goff's 71.4, all in last season. Quite frankly, it was not a fair debate because the former Lions starter was putting on MVP-level performances when Goff was having a miserable season. The superstar was throwing for 2,499 yards plus 19 TDs within 8 games, only while Goff's ratio had dropped to things like recording 42 touchdowns along with 29 picks in 2 years. So, of course, in light of these happenings, the Rams, who fielded a championship-level roster, decided that the missing piece could be Stafford. And with what we've seen so far, the management could very well be correct. Only a handful of quarterbacks could ever manage Stafford's natural and easy arm strength, as well as his deep ball velocity. Not only is he aesthetically gorgeous to behold, but also it is an important part of what has made him the success he is. On the other hand, Jared Goff fans cannot claim the deep ball as one of his strong suits, at least for the last five seasons. The man from Cal has always relied on pinpoint precision and proper spacing on routes to flourish. There's no doubt that Goff is a pretty decent guy who's had some fantastic game plays up his sleeves throughout the time he's spent with the Rams. However, Stafford is just the next level for the team. He brings the much-needed experience to the team and a passer rating that you just cannot deny. I mean, this star is placed fourth in the league's history for career passing yards in each game. Simply put, he can throw balls that Goff would not be able to throw. He can, and so far has found receivers like Goff cannot. He is that leader that you can say the Rams would wish Goff was. The only thing that does not work in Stafford's argument is the fact that he is pretty old at 33. However, that does not really count because out of the league's best 10 passers this year, 5 of them are 32 minimum. So yes, you can assume that there is a sort of veteran QB renaissance going in throughout the league. If that's the case, Stafford has more years to break records. You might also want to question his durability based on the numerous injuries he's had to his middle finger, thumb, ankle, ribs, and back. And yes, injuries ensured that he missed the last 8 matches of the 2019 season. However, remember that the superstar recorded 136 starts in 9 seasons straight. So yes, he shows up for work, and what's more, he doesn't fumble the ball like Goff. In the previous 2 seasons, our star has had 19 turnovers, to which Goff has had about 38. All in all, Stafford may not have youth on his side, but with his experience and quality, the Rams can launch a better title challenge, and so far, he's doing that. And with that, we bring an end to today's video. So what are your thoughts on Mathew Stafford? Do you think he's that good? Do you think he has been a massive contributor to the Rams' perfect start? Let us know what you think in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to leave a like on this video, subscribe to the channel if you're new here, and hit that notification bell to ensure you don't miss our next video and other videos. Thanks for watching. Until next time, keep safe.